afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for being here, and welcome to the SU Orchestra November concert on this beautiful fall day. Sorry that you have to be inside for this. It's too bad we couldn't take the concert outside with us for this. But we're delighted you're here. We're very excited to put on this concert for you all. Obviously, what you just heard was the Schubert Overture to Rosamunde. Schubert, who was a theater enthusiast, he loved the theater, he loved writing for the theater. He wrote, I believe, 12 pieces for the theater, 8 of which are operas and operettas. Unfortunately, all of those flopped. So as he loved writing for it, none of the theater themselves, those pieces worked out so well. He was asked to write incidental music for the play Rosamunde. And he wrote the incidental music, and he finished the incidental music with about 2 days before the actual performance. And he hadn't actually written the overture, which he was also asked to write for as well. So what he did was he reached back into another overture he had, Die Zauberhafer, I believe it's pronounced, the Magic Harp, for another play, which actually wasn't very successful either, and he just plugged it into this one. Now, neither of those plays really amounted to much. In fact, I think Rosamunde just had 2 performances until it was done. But as you can hear, the music is fantastic, and that seemed to last. A couple of other words about some of the other music that we're going to perform. Divertimento, the next piece, was described by Lee Actor as a piece of music as an amusement. It's a lighthearted mood piece for kind of a small orchestra or a small ensemble. The one that you're going to hear has 3 different sections. The first section is driven by 16th notes, a very rhythmic forward motion. There's a second section with a lot of mixed meter. He kind of talks about that as being the off-kilter section. And then a tranquil section, which you don't find really a lot in Divertimenti, but this is sort of subdued, but it has a tremendous climax in the middle of it. And the only thing that Lee Actor said about this Divertimento is actually that it's an amusement, it's lighthearted, it's for small ensemble, but that's it. This wasn't a throwback to the time when they wrote this, this genre of music. After that, you will hear 3 scenes from Humperdinck's opera Hansel and Gretel. The 3 scenes are the Sandman Song, Evening Prayer, and Dream Pantomime. And Humperdinck wrote this opera, actually it was first asked for him to write by his sister, who was putting together a puppet play. And she wanted him to write the music and the opera for that. Well, he did as a favor to his sister, but it was wildly popular and then put on stage and was tremendously well-known and well-loved. So for this scene, this is kind of the conclusion of Act 2. For this scene, it depicts the Sandman Song, and he's Hansel and Gretel are in the woods, as the Grimm fairy tale tells us, and they're about to go to sleep. It's dark at night, and the Sandman comes down, sprinkles sand in their eyes so they can fall asleep. And then they pray their evening prayer, which is asking for the 14 angels to come and protect them. The text for that prayer depicts as such. And then after that, in the dream pantomime, is actually a depiction of that prayer. And then finally, we turn to composer Franz Liszt, who wrote the Hungarian Rhapsody No. 2. This is number 2 of 19 that he wrote, and by far this was one of the most popular. Now, Franz Liszt was one of the greatest pianists in his day, and he wrote this piece, which became very popular. And then it was orchestrated by a friend of his who was actually a flautist. And this piece, with his Hungarian Rhapsody, what he did, and what a lot of composers at this point in their lives did, was they wrote a lot of music based on their culture and the folk tales and the gypsy tales and the gypsy music for that. So he wrote this. It was a very nationalistic time and a time of real cultural pride. Now, you'll probably recognize this piece because it was very famous not only in the day that it came out, but the likes of Walt Disney, Hanna-Barbera, and the Marx Brothers have used it extensively too. So for this piece, our final piece of the program, we're going to try to channel our inner Tom and Jerry for this one. So thank you all so much for coming. We hope you enjoy the rest of the concert.
Thank you. Thank you.
I do want to take a moment to thank somebody who didn't make it to the program because this was kind of the last minute addition, but Dr. Naminga came and was able to cover our piano part. So thank you very much for that, Dr. Naminga. And because we truly believe there's so many wonderful, magnificent things happening, not only in this hall, but throughout on this campus, I want you to take a moment, if you haven't already done so, check the back of your program or a list of dates of things that you should be coming to, not the least of which is next week's musical production in DAG, in the Ministry of Edwin Drood, and then in 2 weeks we have our jazz ensemble concert. I know I'm going to be missing a couple of things, but then the second Tuesday, in December, we will feature the candlelight service, which will happen in Weber Chapel, that will feature a majority of the music department for that. So we hope to see each and every one of you at those performances. Thank you all so very much for coming out and spending part of your Sunday with us, and we hope to leave you with some smiles with Franz Liszt.